the first level, the spirit that prevailed this meeting. It was a meeting to show solidarity to Libya and the Libyans. It was a meeting built on the desire to have good understanding of the developments in Libya. It was also a meeting based on the will of the countries on top of which is Libya, to emphasize to the international community that our role should not be taken lightly, and our countries are influenced by what happens in our neighborhood. So our voice should be heard and our role should be acknowledged. This meeting is distinguished also with the fact that it has very good outcomes. As you find in the communique of this meeting has focused on the rules, the principles that should be attained and on which we should base our work, so that the international group would be able to meet its commitments toward the Libyans, and the decision made by the group should be in line with the international law, as well as the fixed, stable stance of the different groups in Libya, starting with the neighboring countries up till the United Nations and its General Assembly, through the African Union, the League of Arab States, the Organization of Islamic Cooperation and the Non-Alliance Movement, as all these groups emphasize the irrevocable rights of the Libyans, as well as emphasize the fact that this Libyan issue is a sovereign Libyan issue, and it's the explicit right of the Libyans to reach an agreement so that they can enjoy a decent life in light of independence and freedom. Another outcome of this meeting is focusing on the role of the neighboring countries and the fact that the neighboring groups should go on continuously with its work rather than turning it into a seasonal work. We need, as Algeria that presides over this group along with the other members, we want to put ourselves at the disposal of our brothers in Libya. As President Abdelmajid Tebboune, in his meeting today with the participants in this meeting, Algeria is at the disposal of our brothers in Libya. So we are ready to support you. We are exerting all our efforts to assist our brothers in Libya, and we raise our voices whenever needed, calling for respecting the sovereign rights of the Libyans. From different corners of the region and from different dimensions, we consider this meeting to be a successful one, with the President Tebboune's presence in the previous session. We were able to express his continuous support and the continuous support of Algeria to Libya. And this signifies also that this meeting would be a good beginning, and it would be followed up by other initiatives and other meetings, and you will find Libya during the coming phase supported by all its neighbors and brothers. We always will be keen on achieving the outcomes that cope with the aspirations of the Libyans. Sorry for being lengthy, and I give you the floor. Good afternoon. We would like to thank His Excellency Mr. Father Ramadan Amamer, the Foreign Minister of Algeria, for organizing this very successful meeting. And we would like to thank Algeria for hosting this very important meeting for the neighboring countries. Since the first moment till the end, this meeting has one clear message: supporting Libya, supporting the Libyan efforts in achieving its stability. And this is what we have found on part of the administration in the agenda, and they have created the conducive environment for supporting, discussing different issues that would achieve stability in Libya. And the most important thing achieved during this meeting was listening to all the neighboring countries to Libya and to see how insecurity in Libya negatively impacted them and how can we cooperate together all to come up with regional solutions to give momentum to stability in Libya. Another very important point we found during these talks that went over the past 2 days, that the stability of any neighboring country is so important for all other neighboring states. That's why all countries expressed their support to Libya and participating in the consultative meeting expected to be held by the end of next month. Also, the neighboring countries to the south of Libya have always been deprived from participating in the efforts of stabilizing Libya, although they are negatively impacted by everything that happens in Libya. And thanks to the efforts of the minister who gave us this opportunity to meet together to share points of views and to discuss a lot of issues pertaining to Libya, we decided on enforcing the Libyan agreement with other neighboring countries to achieve protection of the common borders and to give us more cooperation on the ground. Also, through the meeting, we emphasized that it is indispensable to unite all our stances to meet the aspirations of the peoples of our region, and one of which is the stability of Libya. Also, there are four objectives that we are seeking to achieve, and we have discussed them today during the sessions and during the points that we agreed upon, that the security of the borders is a top priority. Food security, knowledge, development are all objectives that we as neighboring countries need to work on through opening joint horizons. We have also been given the privilege of meeting President Abdelmajid Tebboune this morning, as he expressed his support to this meeting and this conference, and he positively gave us wise directives to support the outcomes of this meeting and to discuss the stability of Libya and how the neighboring countries can play a positive role for the stability of Libya. What we learned during this period from the history of Libya is to achieve stability and peace in Libya, we need to unite all international efforts and unite efforts of all the neighboring countries to achieve peace and stability. So these are the prominent points that we agreed upon today, in addition to other points that were mentioned in the communique. And I agree with the minister that this was a very positive meeting. It was an open one, and there were a lot of valuable discussions and a lot of working points we agreed upon, thank God, and this meeting would be the beginning of a series of other successive meetings so that we'd be able to follow up this communique and the implementation of the points mentioned in this communique. You can see in the communique that all points are supporting the agenda of Libya and the Libyan efforts to support peace. Thank you. Thank you very much. We'll start receiving the questions. Your Excellency Mohammed Jourada from El Hurra TV. My question is to both ministers. The elections date of Libya, it is expected to be next December. Have you agreed on the same dates? But there are certain difficulties that might postpone the elections. And as for the consultative meeting, when and where would it be held? And if you have more details about the security agreement you reached. Should we take one question at a time or collect more than one question? Okay, let's listen to the reply of Her Excellency the Minister, because this question might be repeated, so let's answer it first. As for your question, it is an important one. Thank you for raising it. Concerning the elections, this is the objective we are all working on, that these elections would be held by the end of December. As for the unity government, we have done everything that is needed to support holding the elections, be it through providing the funding needed for the elections or extending the financial and logistical support to the Elections Commission. And we have also developed a strategic plan to protect the elections by the Ministry of Interior. And we, as Ministry of Foreign Affairs, had a role also in supporting elections and voting for the Libyan expats. So regarding the elections, we discussed it, whether it would be postponed or not. I do not know yet, but we are seeking to hold it on time. And we are doing everything we can. There are a lot of other things. We are waiting, for example, for the parliament to support the legislative foundation for the elections, which might postpone it. As for the consultative meeting, the purpose of this meeting is to consult with foreign ministers of the neighboring and friendly countries that want to support the initiative of Libya stability. This initiative, the stability of Libya, is an initiative that would support the outcomes of Berlin 1 and Berlin 2. And this meeting would discuss the security aspect for Libya, and God willing, it would be by the end of September or during the first week of October. We will decide upon the date during the coming 2 days. And this consultative meeting would be very important, because it would be the first initiative of the National Unity Government through Libyan efforts and Libyan developments in line with Berlin outcomes as well as the roadmap. I cannot remember the last part of your question. Yes, more information about the security agreement. You mean the security agreement that I've just talked about? Yes, the security agreement have two parts. As for the quartet agreement, it is an agreement to protect the borders. It was signed before, but it was not enforced. I do not know about its details, but the mechanism is creating a joint mechanism between the neighboring countries, Niger, Sudan, Chad, and Libya, to create a joint committee for protecting the borders. As you know, in light of the infiltration of our borders, irregular migration and trafficking and smuggling, we are putting a strategy now to secure our borders and the borders of the neighboring countries. Thank you. Good afternoon, Hamza Kahal Nahar. My question is to both ministers. To what extent have the neighboring countries agreed on the outcomes of this meeting, and Egypt and Cairo in particular? We know that the stances of Cairo in the past sometimes was controversial. And as we are discussing the elections, of course, there would be certain things that would be done to stop the path towards the elections. There is the problem of the mercenaries, and solving this problem does not lie only in the hands of Libya. It lies in the hands of other countries. So what are the practical mechanisms to get the mercenary out of Libya? I'll answer this question. To answer this question concerning the role of Cairo, of course, Egypt plays a vital, important role, and Egypt is considered to be one of the important members in the neighboring countries group, and Egypt has its specificity. We share borders with Egypt as we share borders with Tunisia and the southern countries, and the security of Egypt and Libya are national security for both countries. If there are certain differences regarding the discourse or some sentences, we do not consider them to be differences so long as we are able to reach a communique. So I think that coming up with this communique proves that there is an agreement and that there is a commitment to support Libya and to cooperate with the neighboring countries. Concerning the mercenary, one of the points that was agreed upon, and it's point 7 on the communique, it says the ministers emphasized once more the pivotal role of the neighborhood mechanism to consult through the political dialogue forum and to coordinate through Libya's 5+5 commission and the neighboring countries regarding the withdrawal of the mercenaries and the foreign forces to come up with a practical support and cooperation between Libya and neighboring countries. So to achieve this 5+5 commission is a technical commission, a commission that enjoys international, local and regional credibility. And this is the commission that would put the time frame for the withdrawal of the foreign forces and the mercenary. So through dialogue and working with the neighboring countries, we will achieve this mechanism and find a method for the withdrawal of the forces and the mercenary. Thank you. I have one point to add. I think that the security aspect of achieving the outcomes of Berlin and the decision of the Security Council regarding getting the forces out of Libya, as their presence hampers the normal developments in Libya. So we of course agreed on this, but it's the practical arrangements to implement it that we need to focus on right now. The neighboring countries raised a number of principles that should be taken into consideration on part of Libya's 5+5 commission and all the other mechanisms, including the Security Council, when we know that this principle was implemented and the arrangements and preparations are done to achieve this objective through creating full opportunity for elections that would be held without any pressure from foreign countries. So we expect that we will discuss this further. There would be a lot of deliberations regarding this point through the relevant authorities and agencies. It is the right of the neighboring countries to focus on that. It is unclear up till now these illegitimate forces that are on the land of Libya, where they are going to go. Maybe the logical idea would be that those parties that sent those in Libya should take them from Libya back to the countries they came from. And this is the only way that would make us sure in the neighboring countries that we will not fall victims to unorganized, unmonitored departure of those forces from Libya. So the neighboring countries have specific ideas, and they have what they can contribute with for the coming discussions to achieve this principle. So we agreed on this principle, and there are certain arrangements that we need to work on accurately to make sure that the application of this principle won't lead to any problems to the neighboring countries. This is what we agreed upon in principle. So we should now try to find the needed preparations for that. Regarding the role of Egypt in our work, I think that it is suitable, similar to the role that Egypt has always played regarding Libya and other issues. Egypt works with the brothers, and the diplomatic work also has different opinions, different views, but finally we reach an agreement. So Egypt, like all other countries that participated, supports what was mentioned in the communique. And we think that this is the main principle on which we base our work, that we have convened to support Libya, to mobilize our support, our political assistance to achieve our joint objectives. So from this, I think that the basis is the interest of Libya, the principles we believe in and we consider to be the normal framework for solution, and not parts here and there. You as journalists, maybe when you analyze our speeches and our rhetoric, would consider that this is related to one country or two countries, but we are all united, we have all agreed on these outcomes, and we are all neighboring countries to Libya, and we are all showing solidarity and support to it. Thank you. Other questions? The Minister of Foreign Affairs. My question, there has been an agreement between the neighboring countries on reconciliation, stability and security in Libya. So I would like to ask about the international forces working on the Libyan file. Did you find that they are ready to support you with your efforts? My question is also about the Arab summit that would be held in Algeria, as this is an addition to the joint Arab action. So Mr. Minister, what are the most important files that would be discussed during the Arab summit? My third question is to the head of diplomacy in Libya. Welcome to your second country, Algeria. Do you think that things are moving towards elections, and that things in Libya are ready for these elections? So are the elections expected to be held? Maybe you will answer the questions pertaining to Libya, and I will answer about the Arab summit that would be held in Algeria. As for elections, as I mentioned before to your colleague, that we tried to play our role in supporting the elections, but is it possible during the current givens? I think that there are a lot of challenges, especially security, economic. We have a lot to do to support the elections. That's why the initiative of Libya stability appeared, because stability is the priority. There should be stability in the country, relatively, at least, so that we can hold the elections. So from my perspective, we are discussing the issue of legitimacy and stability, and I think that both should move in the same direction. We should work on stability of the country so that there would be legitimacy and elections would be held, and the elections should come before stability, as this would create, God forbid, security troubles. And we do not want Libya to face another civil war or other political difficulties. I forgot, what was the other question about Libya? Regarding the Arab summit that would be held in Algeria and the most important files that would be tackled in it. I think that you've covered all the questions. Let me also add to her answer that getting out of the crisis in Libya necessitates national reconciliation and national settlement, and all texts, including Berlin outcomes, stipulate that the brothers in Libya can benefit from the Algerian experience with the national reconciliation. So we emphasize that we are ready to share our experience with Libya so that Libya would benefit from our lessons learned through our process for national reconciliation and studying other successful national reconciliations in the African countries like South Africa, Rwanda, and other African countries. So national reconciliation is a main pillar for peace. There would be no sustainable peace without real national reconciliation and coexisting in light of respecting all opinions, all people and everyone in the country. So we pin a lot of hope on national reconciliation in Libya, and we are fully ready to share with them our experience and to share with them our modest experience. As for the Arab summit, let us say that the elections in Libya, if they succeed and if they are held before the end of this year, and this is what we wish for, would create a very positive environment for the success of the Arab summit. Because throughout all the previous years, the Libyan crisis was one of the most important files, and it was like a nightmare for the Arab joint action and the Arab meetings. Because there were different contradicting opinions that appeared during our discussions, although everybody recognized that what happened in Libya and the intervention in the internal affairs of Libya was contradicting with the fraternal relations that should be there between Arab countries. So, if this challenge is removed and Libya would get back to normal and participate and hold its elections and provide what it can do for joint Arab action, then this would be a great contribution to the success of the Arab summit. Also, for the Arab summit, there should be other things for its success. There are talks and consultations taking place to achieve rapprochement between different countries regarding different issues, with the main things, the desire to support the joint Arab action to serve the Palestinian cause, and the title of this joint Arab action to serve the Palestinian cause is holding on to the Arab Peace Initiative. The Arab Peace Initiative as a joint Arab will, as an Arab initiative, is still valid. And Algeria is one of the countries that is holding on to this initiative, and I think that no one refuses the Arab initiative despite different opinions regarding its implementation as solidarity with the Palestinians will cement the joint Arab action and all the efforts. So we need to revive this solidarity and make it the pillar that we all cling on to. Of course, the joint Arab action has economic dimensions as well as other dimensions like facing COVID-19, the pandemic, and it is also related to serving the joint future vision for the Arab region. I think that the summit will be held on time through good preparation for it, and Algeria, of course, is ready to host it. And before that, Algeria is ready to make more efforts to achieve the elements for the success of this summit. Peace be upon you. La Patrie News.